Hello, ladies and gentlemen. We're back. Hey. It's dinner time here at the BTS house. Our producer apparently forgetting to hit some buttons, but we've got a game 2 ready for you. As Digital Chaos takes on Unknown.
Yeah.
Felt like they had the control of the game in game 1, guys. They were cutting all the waves. They took a free range Drax. They took a tier 3 for free. They did half damage to another tier 3. They were slightly getting out farmed, but with the better map control and the PL for late game, but
at some point the
hex on the Darkseer and everything just started to crumble.
At some point, DC have to realize they need to take a fight and they need to know when that point is, and that's been their issue every single series that they've lost. And
I agree.
Haven't learned their lesson so far. I don't expect them to win this series.
Yeah,
actually,
we've decided as a group that it's very unlikely that they're going to win this game after losing that first one.
Reserve time.
Yep, that's all there is to it.
Yep.
No, don't even. Okay.
To be fair, we shouldn't be defeatists like that.
Well, I also think Unknown. It's not just that DC played poorly. Unknown made a lot of good decisions. There, like they went for it as well. There were buybacks available. They had used some cooldowns. They still just bulldozed down the lane, forced the racks. They were decisive. So it's not just that DC wasn't, but it's also that Unknown was. And I think that's important to keep in mind that this is a young, fairly inexperienced team, especially on the big stage, and they made clutch decisions. Sure, they had their moments where they got picked off. TA, a couple of sloppy deaths, item selection, I still think left something to be desired with the Moonshard and the Lincolns, both to me a bit underwhelming compared to other options, but it worked. And here they are, leading 1-0. Viva Peru.
I hope that Unknown just, like, take this game, play it the way they really get to play it, and just run at DC, because I think if they do that, DC will actually just crumble.
I think so as well. I think, like, last game, DC had sort of all their comfort picks. Aoi, Visage, Queen of Pain,
like all the heroes
TC, PL. I think the one thing that was a little not so comfort was Bulba Beastmaster, but he's fine
on
that.
He played fine.
Yeah,
I don't think that Yu Yu was the reason they lost that game.
They had everything they wanted, and at the end of the day, what they haven't fixed is just when do you man up?
Yeah, when do you
and to some extent, that's just a lack of team leadership, it seems like, from the outside, at least.
Sure.
But, okay, back to the draft, guys. Let's focus on the heroes now. We had a Darkseer first overall pick, possibly a bit of a block pick as well for Digital Chaos after the way that last game went. Unknown going to reply with the Ogre Wyvern. Neither of these really supports that they tend to favor, especially the Ogre, which I can't recall even seeing them run. They generally go for the Tusk instead for Z-Talk, but
pretty down with Ogre, though.
They'll grab 2 supports in the first phase. They leave their options open. Now, this team has run some very playmaking-oriented carries when they've been at their finest. Queen of Pain, we saw Storm Spirit. Those two went off in their series in the winner's bracket, round 1, versus Elite Wolves. So, what direction do you think they take? Digital Chaos, they ban Huskar, who, I mean, hardly did anything last game. Basically had no kills, didn't even secure them Roche.
I think they're
tanked
afraid
a bit in the final fight.
I think they're afraid of what it could do to them this draft. You know, it's interesting because if you covered up the team names, I would have actually thought that DC
were swapped.
Yeah.
That's what I'm saying. Yeah, those two feel like DC picks.
Yeah.
Maybe Unknown felt they wanted the Ogre because that's generally an AUI hero.
I can't say he's generally very effective on it, though.
That Ogre?
Yeah.
Yeah, the games that he played Ogre, they did not do very well.
He had the one really good game yesterday.
You know what I think some of it is? His diminished impact in a lot of these games. He isn't the same greedy core that he has been on other teams. He's the captain now. He is calling a lot of the shots, so I think he is probably not a little comfortable.
Do you
not
think it's
comfortable
taxing him a bit mentally?
Oh, of course. Individual play? Of course it is.
Has he ever been a... I don't think Aoi's ever been a captain.
No, he never has been. And something that all captains have said in the past that is about, you know, when you take the mantle of leadership, it definitely impacts your play. It is much easier, much more relaxing to sort of just, you know, you do your thing.
Hit creeps, you know, go where you're told.
Yeah.
Gank when you're supposed to.
I've heard so many core players say, if I if I were to switch to support, the only role that I would want to play is like the EGM type support. You don't say anything. You don't buy wards. You go around. You hit creeps. You
get
like,
items.
You do whatever you want. Yeah, yeah.
All right. So Gyro, the grab here for Unknown, has fallen a bit out of favor as a carry, but known particularly for his ability to just dominate the safe lane against pretty much any opposition. So up against a Darkseer, this could actually give the Darkseer quite a bit of trouble early on. And now a Bane grab by Digital Chaos, a real changeup. Good against BKB carries, a strong ganker, but they don't have a great hero to gank with the Bane just yet. And we'll have to see. What do Unknown want for mid? Swagger Fiendban, TA is available. You are up against Ion Shell and the Poison Sting. So there's quite a bit of damage over time. Or, sorry, did I say Sting? I meant Shadow Strike.
Yeah, close.
I almost got one of the words right. There you go.
Well, moving forward here, Unknown. I wonder what kind of mid they're going to pick. And do you think that this is going to be...
All right.
Okay, well, if it... worked well
we beat you with
time.
It last time. We're gonna do it again. That's the call.
I think what's TA's win record during these qualifiers? I feel like it's super high. It's a hero that's really hard to deal with, especially mid. It's like one of those annoying heroes that it's hard to gank up, just because of refraction. And
they're gonna double down on control for the TA. Grabbing the Venno now.
This is okay. It's like, you know, one of those heroes you don't really want to gank. You take fights easily, or you can take fights pretty easily with it, just because you just spread that shit everywhere. But
you just spread that shit everywhere. Every time you describe Venno, it's always good and it's always hitting.
Honestly, I hate that hero so much. I hate playing against it. I hate seeing it. You just see these like wards, and they just like. And they just pick at you. They cancel your bottle. They disable your blink dagger.
That's actually the most annoying thing, is when you're just walking along, about to start a team fight, and then your blink is disabled.
And then you want to start a fight. You go in or whatever. You maybe kill the Venno, but he gets off his aids, and everyone's just, it's bad.
Everyone's sad.
Yeah, Venno's a terrible hero.
I mean, you kill him, but you still lose the fight. Yeah.
I know Fear City wanted Lich and Viper removed from Dota, but Venno's pretty high on my list as well.
Oh, yeah, for
heroes,
sure.
Heroes that should be deleted from the game permanently.
We got Legion Commander, which is...
I hardly ever see this hero win.
All of these heroes seem so strange to see on Unknown, except for the Templar Assassin. This is a little weird.
This LC pick.
I can kind of see the Gyro. The Ogre...
Does...
I'm wondering why that wasn't just a Tusk, like, which Z-Tok has been... immensely impressive on.
I think Legion is okay here in the sense that you can heal through the poison. And does it take off Poison Sting?
I don't know. Mechanics like that. All
right, I dislike this DC draft so much. I don't. What's the point here? What are they trying to accomplish? Is this early game, late game? Are they trying to push?
Kinda,
are they?
It's like a hodgepodge of everything. It kind of reminds me vaguely of like the old LGD int drafts, where you'd like look to get the fast mech on Darkseer and five man with the Luna. But
sure.
Dota has changed.
I don't think.
And
that's
some of these heroes don't fit that well into that
like
type
Bane.
Of style necessarily. At the same time, Unknown are not drafting their bread and butter picks, so that could.
I think it's going to get to a point where DC just doesn't punish Unknown. And those three cores are just going to get to a point where it's just so easy for them to win fights.
I'm looking forward to seeing how Ryo does on the Legion. 5 seconds
remaining. If he does well, this game could end very quickly.
I mean, I think
it's like
this
a fast
game
blink.
Charlie, yeah, let me tell you, your motivational speeches need some work if you're trying to pump up the DC boys.
I am not their manager. That is Pandago.
All right, well, let's get into it. Unknown looking to become the first ever South American team to make it to a Valve event, to make it to a major, and to compete for $3 million. Z-Tok just missed the smoke barely, but they're going in, and they're going into five DC heroes. We may have a very fast rumble in the jungle. They're going to lead with the Ogre for now, as he is their main source of initiation. Now they're going to let other heroes get in front. Stay close together. Luna scouts it out. It's just an Ogre. Here are you. Ogre wants to go in. What else could there possibly be here?
Team.
Burr, are you getting slowed? Do they engage onto this? This is a long way to dive. He takes the club. TC waiting, looking for the early kills. Rocket Barrage comes out from the gyro, but he gets galed on the way back. Needs a little bit of help. The five hero grab on the overwhelming odds. Still, first man down is the copter. And now DC in pursuit. They're going to lose Hoshi, potentially. And maybe more. Body blocks coming out from Z-Talk. Hoshi makes it out. Instead, he says, take me, take me. TC gets the last auto attack. He's dead. And the ogre's going to die as well. It's a three-man wipeout. Well, if DC needed a confidence boost, there
sure.
It is.
We'll see how long that lasts.
You're not giving them a good chance after that.
They got a triple kill.
Yeah, sure.
I can't even take... I don't even know what to tell. I don't know what to say. Well... Luna is really the one who won out on that. He got two of those kills.
So a 1,200 gold lead, a 400 experience lead at 17 seconds into the game. Nice start here for DC. That's definitely the shot in the arm you'd like to have when trailing 0-1 and your lives are on the line. We're going to see the early sentry. Same thing for Yawar as what we saw in previous matchups, just to ensure that you cannot meld dodge that Shadow Strike, but it is the Psyblades build. At least for now. T already with three denies and two last hits in the first wave. This is a beatdown.
I think if I had to pick a player that I'd be most worried about tilting.
AUI! He's what? Trapped by the trees! Oh, he almost goes down. Z-Talk has another ignites coming soon. Oh, that
Luna got two kills. DC got three kills. Luna got two of them in the very beginning. And they are getting bullied in this lane.
Yeah.
So what I was going to say, if there's any player on DC that, you know, traditionally has had a tilting problem, it's probably Yawar. So I think mid lane is actually going to be even more important than usual, because if like something weird happens and he dies like once or twice.
For Yawar, I can actually see this going either way. I can see him being more motivated by it, or just, you know, completely.
He's looking for the jump, but there's a refraction and Blink already expended. They're going to force the tri lane back a little bit. So look at the actual lane setup here. We do see a Darkseer versus Legion 1v1. Creep skipping Bulba playing aggressive here early on. Tri lane not slowing down the Luna's farm, though she took a pretty heavy beating from that first wave of damage. TA in the mid lane, up a bit on the Quap in terms of CS, suffering in terms of the regen, though, as she's been heavily harassed. And now they're going to make a move. Hoshimiki over towards mid. Yomar almost dead. Not quite in range for the Arctic Burn. Gets the mana needed for a blink. Courier also escaping. Yomar dodging bullets here.
Z-Talk really needs to get level 2 and top so he has Fire Blast. There we go.
It's an interesting decision to for Unknown to go aggressive tri-lane here.
Yeah, especially at, you don't see many teams give up a triple kill and still go aggro try.
Yeah, do you really need to contest the Luna that much?
I mean, I think they have better late game if they're equally farmed.
Blinks
forward into Hoshimiki. He wants the TA kill, but embraced, kept alive as the TP comes in from Bane, who has the level 1 brain sap just out of range, trying for it, diving for it.
Oh my god,
there
what?
There was a refraction in 1 second.
What?
Well, I guess this series got more interesting all of a sudden.
I wouldn't underestimate DC's ability to just...
Collapse
and crumble in the late game, so...
Interesting stat that Motpax tweeted out during the intermission. He said that in games that are 50 minutes or longer, DC are 2-7. So you definitely would think that they'd like to close this one out early to maximize the statistical chance of winning. Buryu, though, does get hit by the slow of the Arctic Burn, and now
he's
they're on the run.
Dead.
They've got him where they want him, down in the river. Goes for the self-deny. Not going to happen. Quick, easy kill.
TC is still farming extremely well, up to 20 CS, so it's a bright spot.
Now, bear in mind it's a Luna. You farm well in this hero early, you get slightly out of position. Look, 587 health against the gyrocopter. Very easy to feed here.
Yeah. UR is actually kind of getting wrecked mid. 22 CS for the TA.
Well, the wrecking is going to continue, Greg, let me tell you. Oh, double damage rune now bottled up.
You know, that's certainly going to make it more difficult. Bulba, still playing aggressively. He's up there at CS as well, 21.
Legion's actually doing really well.
Yeah, Legion was struggling for a bit, but now doing much better.
Yeah, the mango. Like I said, I think for Yawar, this game, he was either going to go god mode or he was going to tilt super hard. I think you are seeing which we're seeing which one we're going to get this game. It's definitely not the god mode you are.
Yeah.
15-3. Lane only gets harder from here. Does get the scream off, but the CS just keeps on piling in for your TA.
Yeah, he's getting a lot of denies as well.
Up 8-8 on last hits and CS respectively. And looks like they may begin stacking Ancients now for the Templar Assassin. Trying to have that explosive mid game once again for Orange.
The one thing I do really have a problem with is this top lane's not really doing anything without Buryu on Wyvern. Without Hoshi here.
Oh, they're going to have to sack the Ogre here. Tries to zone them out a bit.
Deny? Oh, no.
I think he tried for it, but didn't have the right HP.
Yawar is definitely struggling mid.
They are winning their safe lane pretty hard, though.
Yeah, the safe lane is going really
well. Gyro has 11 CS. Luna has 32.
Yeah, safe lane is going very well for them, but this TA is super good at using Psyblades.
Yawar has the ultimate. Refraction dodges it.
Oh my. That is rage inducing.
Baiting it out. Well played there by the TA, but
that was a pretty high risk play considering they're playing on Packet Loss. But it definitely worked out for him. So.
I guess maybe it's not as laggy, or they probably would have paused again.
Yeah.
Looking for the 6-minute rune now. Well, the Queen of Pain.
Oh, have
the now the GG rune.
Seriously?
This
he's
can
got,
wreck the tri lane.
He's got DD haste.
But he's farming the Ancients with the DD. Interesting. Well, should be able to get him towards his completed Aquila if he wants it, the early upgraded boots.
I think I would have rathered if he went top of the pace, but...
And actually, as it turns out, they would not have seen him. They had no idea what the ward was. They're actually playing very aggressively, considering that.
Here comes two supports from Unknown.
Scouted by the ward.
Wonderful Venomancer ward.
I mean, they would have had a plague ward down, but if he's hasted and sprinting in there, they do not get him.
Now he uses the haste, and he's going to use it to try to damage Yawar a little bit. I wonder if we're... I mean, I feel like he needs a level of meld soon just so we can dodge those shadow strikes, but I guess it's only level 2, and last game he put 3 levels into Psyblades instead.
Now that he's got the bottle, the stick, the Wraith Band as well, and probably Aquila or upgraded boots coming soon though,
it's less of a big deal.
You have more regen, so you're less vulnerable to the early harass. That's particularly effective when it's like levels 1 to 3. So, I don't know. I mean, he's going to get meld anyway, because you don't need more than 2 points in Psyblades early. But farming the Ancients now, clearing them up.
Oh, wow.
Looking for the wraparound. AUI is in a bit of a little... Oh, this is bad. AUI about to be caught out. They slow him down. They give him the old ignite, and now he goes for the TP, but Fire Blast says, get back here. You're mine.
Now Luna's all alone in top. There's 4 Radiant heroes here.
Oh, they want to
Legion
punish.
Is here. If they can get a duel, you start
wanna,
stacking that damage.
You want to check net worth?
Oh, good call. TC almost has Eclipse, though. But that's a tanky Ogre. It'd take like almost a whole Eclipse to bring him down. Meanwhile, they have rotated Buryu. They want to pressure the enemy safe lane. Probably also trying to dodge as the Queen of Pain ult again chucked out by Yawar. Did not
that was
go
very
for the scream
optimistic.
Follow up. And that's 2 whiffed ultimates in a row for him. It does seem like the frustration may be
Yawar
setting in a bit.
Definitely tilting.
And now the tower bottom goes down. This could be an opportunity for DC. There's no teleport. TC's here as well, has the Eclipse at the ready, just wants to use the Lucent Beam and hang on to the Eclipse. Juking through the trees, Ryo, no backup remotely in sight.
Yeah, he's dead.
They hang on to the Eclipse, they get the easy kill.
Space created, maybe we'll be able to get top tower off this.
Honestly, kind of sloppy play all around. Both teams are definitely feeling the pressure here in game number 2.
These are pretty weird drafts from both teams. It's not
weird drafts, weird plays.
It's not what you would typically see.
A lot on the line. I think things are going to get a lot harder for DC, though. Cooldown's about to come into play. TA's got the treads up now. Works on the Deso or the Blink. They want to rotate on her. This could be big. Is there going to be backup in time? The Sleep comes in right as the Shadow Strike does, actually causing it to dodge. And now he turns with that Meld, engages onto Buryu. They're bringing in the Ogre. They need to finish us off this TA. Denied by
the
Ogre.
Oh, my God. nothing is going right for DC after that triple kill.
That's actually, I mean,
They're winning. I wouldn't say nothing is going right, but it feels, I mean, things are not going okay, nearly as
not
well
going
as they
well
could
for
be.
UR.
Yeah,
that
for
is
UR,
really what
I
mean.
Would agree.
Not really DC. I mean, Luna is doing extremely well, but UR is, I don't know.
This is going to be a frustrating game for him. Yeah. I mean, Queen of Pain versus TA is, it's one of those matchups that is incredibly frustrating for the Queen of Pain. It's so hard to kill the TA, and you feel like you want to be able to do more, but you just can't.
So you're going to clear out the mid lane now. Gyro level 6 is active, but he's low on mana as well as HP. Let's see. Ferrying out. Just the teleport scroll, it looks like, as well as a circlet. They have blocked the Ancients here. The next rune spawn will be a regen. Buryu prepping on the high ground. They want to try to isolate Hoshimiki, but he Arctic burns up. Yawar in pursuit, really forcing this one, has the ultimate. Now going to back off. That would not have been a successful dive. And it seems he's trying his best to settle down after a rough laning stage. Truth be told, not that far down on CS.
He hasn't died yet.
Yeah.
No. TA is actually getting very, very close to
Luna. She's getting pressured a lot. They've been bringing in some extra heroes on her. And you can see they really want to protect the TA now, just tri-laning mid.
Yeah.
Even pulling her a Tango.
Still, the Luna is farming very well. Looking like it's going to be HOD. So, unsurprisingly, DC is looking to farm this game out a little bit more.
They also have a mech. This could be really big with the Luna. Again, something LGD International used to rely on heavily way back after, I think it was shortly after TI2 when they were doing that. It was very successful. Duar having a fish. He is baiting pretty hard with the refraction not being activated. Now the Quap jumps in. Finally, Yawar connects for a kill. That's got to feel good.
AUI gets it, though. He got it with the ward.
Hey, at least it's a kill.
TA is going to be going directly for the Desolator, unsurprisingly.
No surprises there, but...
No, I mean, he was...
Seems like the plan for DC with the draft is, after the very early laning stage, start really applying pressure to towers, but... I think this is... If Gyro rotates at the right time, that could really get punished. They have to be careful about how they go in.
Yeah, I agree. It could get ugly very, very fast if they're not careful.
Do you want to check the Ancient stacks? TC finished his hot.
They have... No.
Zero.
AUI's been taking it by himself.
AUI! Suck, suck! Running in. TA gets caught by the Gale. Needs to hit with side blades if she wants to get the kill. AUI! Is he going to go down? One more auto attack! Does die to the club. And now Z-Tuck get a TP out. Back is there. Bulba with the salvage. And while that was going on, Bane also finding a kill on the Legion commander elsewhere. Yawar
being
hit by the TA.
He's actually dead.
Gets soloed. But perhaps Bulba can clean this one up.
No, he's not getting this.
There's another bottle charge. Gyro in the neighborhood. The wall comes out. The plays. Bulba now trying to run,
no.
But the cooldown's waiting. Blaze him out. While that was all going on, do want to point out Legion also got killed by the Bane, as well as TC, I believe. But they have just fed the TA... Effectively the Desolator.
Yep.
Pretty much has the second Mithril Hammer.
Yeah, the bright spot for DC, well, there's two. One is the fact that still Luna is farming extremely well. And the other is that the Legion keeps getting the blink pretty heavily delayed. Just died twice now while trying to get it.
At the end of the day, I think we're just going to see we're gonna see more of that Queen of Pain play.
Oh, he's got to pull it together here. Has not progressed at all in items. They were actually only a couple hundred gold off, even though he had a bunch of missed opportunities, very close to getting kills. He wasn't that far behind in net worth, but after that engagement, now he's down 2K on the Templar Assassin. Jumping in again once Yoshimiki. Ultimate cooling down, but the cooldown's waiting, and Yawar's committed to blink. He's caught by the Rocket Brush, dies under the tower. AUI slithers away.
All right.
Nope. Well, honestly,
if he wasn't already tilting, he sure as hell is now.
Yeah, he went from having no deaths to 2 deaths very quickly, both off of really way too aggressive blinks.
They're ganky mid, but even if they get this kill, TA has already bought the Desolator.
Yeah, so this kill doesn't really mean much, even if they do get it. Looks like
they still go for it.
Yeah, Dust comes out, back him back, Refraction removed, Ogre with the long range lob. Work, work. But he can't save him.
Well, it's feeling like this game might mostly be up to Bulba and TC.
Yeah. I mean, it is also up to Yward.
Are you running in?
Relax.
Actually, no. It's Zatok running in. The backup's not here just yet, but Wyvern's in position. No Winter's Curse as of yet. Now the Aluna Eclipse rains down. Hoshimiki sneaks through the trees. Back. The cooldowns arrive. This could be really bad. The mech, the counterplays. They need their Templar Session. She's dead for a bit too long.
Ult, Yward? Yward?
Zatok drop the ultimate. Has the... No blink. Oh just my. The scream. Still, they get three. Gyro lucky to live, but now Legion has cobbled together a blink, and some proper initiation will emerge for Unknown, something they have been lacking heretofore.
I think that now that the Tia has the Deso and Legion has a blink, this game is going to get really...
I don't even think he screamed. Like, not even Sonic Wave, but he didn't even scream for the...
So the Deso just got revealed.
Yeah, I think this game is going to get ugly now that the Tia has a Deso and the Legion has a really good initiation tool. DC have to play this extremely tightly, and to be honest, I'm not sure they're going to be able to do that.
They do have aggressive wards. Got some good vision here for DC, although one of them wearing off soon. Let's see. What does Ryo do with his first blink dagger reveal? I think it was scouted when he rotated on mid, and now he pokes his head out. That's one thing I think Unknown need to do a better job with, is like when they had the Hex last game and the blink this game, that's something... You want to wait until you have an opportunity to get your first kill before you reveal.
They just smoked right under a dire ward.
And unfortunately, yeah, the ward is right there. Generally, you'll see teams kind of poke back like to this area before they smoke, which is less likely to be warded. It's a deep dive. DC moving into position. They're in an awkward location. Burr, you looking to reveal this, but they can get the Wyvern over the trees if they'd like. Smoke not yet broken. They discover the enemy ancient stack, and AUI runs into it. The Legion Blade comes out. It's going to find Yuar off the bat. Do they get the dual win? Tries to
nice
deny
nightmare.
Him, hangs on, but it is a double kill. They get the winner as well. And now TC and Buryu.
Cursed
is no their follow-up.
They're all poison Novid. They need to get out of
here.
They want the ancients. They're being a little greedy. Bulba moving to position. Back. Wall on three. But he gets multicasted. He's sticking around for the ancients. He really wants these things. And Buryu finds the first counter kill as Legion will drop. Still walks away with a dual win. And that's already a level 2 duel.
Yeah, what a disgusting hero Venomancer is.
That's a level 1 poison Nova, by the way.
Well, that could have gone worse for DC. They still have their ancients.
The issue is that the hero that's really getting punished is a Quap, and that hero does not play well from behind.
Are they gonna... What?
Ooh. Bold little maneuver here, but there's a trap in the pit.
They don't take this very fast.
There we go.
Well, they do have a medallion, but...
Well, trap's dead now. I guess they're just... They may have to let it go. No Winter's Curse.
No Legion Commander, but...
I think they just...
No, they're good. They're going to contest
this. There's a
level
2 Eclipse. Vacuum wall... vacuum's up, but the wall's on cooldown.
They're smoke. They're running
forward.
They're
streaming in. This time, it was not scouted. Z-Tok's going to be the first man in. Wants to just lob out the stun. Remember, there's also no Poison Nova for this Roshan attempt. TA trying to wait for the team. Buryu, they isolate the TA. Can they focus? Their TC got best by the Rosh. He runs in. The Eclipse beams need to be good, but Refraction takes the majority of it. They're trying to finish off TC.
We're so close to killing TC.
One more auto attack doesn't quite get it, but the Gyro goes ham, chasing forward. Luna dies on the periphery of the fight. Now Bulba trap with it, and he wants the Rosh. Who's going to get it? The Radiant Doom!
No.
They grab the Aegis. They're going to duel Bulba. He's dead as well. Another kill piling in as Unknown close in on becoming very known. Oh,
how
big fight for them, and the graph spikes straight up.
I don't understand how they went into that Rosh without putting the sentry first. Because they went in and then put the sentry.
That entire fight was so sloppy.
Eclipse hit almost entirely Refraction. They didn't have the wall.
They didn't get. Didn't have Nova.
TC got bashed by Rosh when the fight started. I think Bulba got bashed by Rosh once in the pit. They didn't have Nova.
It's like half the team wanted to do something and the other half wanted to do something else.
Uh-oh. Duel is ready. Aegis is up. Yuar is an easy solo kill, I think, at this point. Jumping in, gets the duel, hacking away at the Queen of Pain. Needs one more. He gets it. Winner up to plus 42. And Queen of Pain has officially become food. The transition, unfortunately, is complete.
Yeah, this... I don't know. This feels like, I don't know, it feels like DC are just not communicating well, not making the best decisions, but Unknown are doing their best to capitalize it. I mean, that Roche fight ended up going so well for them.
The biggest worry for me is you look at this late game, like, unless there's an amazing vacuum wall, Unknown just destroy them in terms of damage output. They get BKBs. The Venomancer is pretty much useless. Luna needs a ton of items to do heavy physical damage. Legion snowballing already has a blade mail up, and there's no BKBs remotely in sight. And even if you are, if you don't get your BKB off, the duel still ruins you. Even if you're farm, you can always be cursed. Like, the, to me, the late game matchup grossly favors Unknown if the teams are even on farm, barring, like, the godliest possible Darkseer plays.
Yeah, and, I mean, Unknown are...
All right, Bulba, how much of a hero can you be?
Yeah, this is Bulba's time to shine. He has done it before. He carried Liquid on his back, kicking, dragging, and screaming to victory over LGD at TI3, but... He's not on Clockwork, and this is a different time, a different place. We'll need the old magic. We need it soon.
Unknown are gathering up on middle. They will have to possibly deal with a little bit of backstab going on here. TC looking like he actually probably just wants to farm these creeps, and maybe they're going to push bottom, but...
One thing that's scary also is they have Bloodlust. That's something we haven't really talked about. That makes all of their late game damage that much more ridiculous. Yeah, already hitting for over an attack per second. We're going to move up through their own jungle, trying to catch the fleeing DC heroes. They drop a ward, but Ryo looks for the engagement. He's got the blink ready. The ward didn't hit him. He jumps in onto the Luna. Blade mail. Oh, it's insta-canceled. The grip by Buryu. And they commit an eclipse solely on an Aegis. Now the... Oh, beautiful cooldown coming in. There's the Winter's Curse as well. And now Legion re-engages, jumping onto Bulba. The duel's there. TC trying to get the hell out as quickly as possible. Another winner. Plus 56 damage. They did buy back on their Ogre for this, but they get three big beefy cores, and they only lose a Gyro and an Ogre. So a 3-for-1 on the cores and an Aegis, but it was an Aegis that was expiring fairly soon.
Yeah, and now TA is going to go take some of these Ancients. I do think that Unknown need to concentrate a bit more on trying to get better map control. There's still a tier 1 up bottom, so potentially could provide DC with some easier access to Roche if that puts them in a better position, but... Unknown are playing this game very, very well. They're picking their fights well, and part of it is honestly that DC have been really sloppy in their executions, and like in that they all retreated. They were extremely separated. They didn't really evacuate as a group, and as a result, this scrappy fight definitely goes in the way of the Unknown.
Yeah.
Unknown just like to run at people, yeah. Honestly. And it reminds me a lot of Empire before TI5, where at their best, they would just dominate the lanes and just constantly hunt you. As TC doesn't have a TP on cooldown, could be in a little bit of danger here. Looks like he'll be able to skate out. And I feel like DC are just getting caught off guard by these rotations time and again. Vision wise, they have got great wards up now. More defensive. You can see their posture has shifted after a series of very awkward fights. Still only trailing by 3,000 gold. A little over 5,000 experience, but oh, TA on the hunt. Knows there's no Eclipse. Can go for TC without fear.
At the end of the day, I think the DC have to commit so much to kill just one person.
And what happens when someone gets a BKB? Where's your single target burst?
Very close to getting.
They need to grip and like unload everything on a target.
And Unknown have, they're not getting hit by all of this AoE at once.
Yeah.
They're
getting the jump
Yeah, they're spread out with the for the Venomancer ult, for the Luna ult, for the those Clop screams have not been very good. I think DC had the lineup to win. The execution is just not there.
DC, they started this game with a triple kill and a first blood.
You think about it that way.
It sure doesn't feel like it right now. They won their safe lane. I would say they broke even bottom. And mid, honestly, yeah, it looked terrible for UR in terms of wasting the Quap ult. The net worth was almost dead even. But you could just see the frustration piling up. Missed ult after missed ult, or ults that were barely blocked by a refraction at the last second. And he just kept on pressing a little more. And then everyone from DC kind of got sucked into it. Now they move. Trying to secure the enemy Ancients, perhaps. Hoshimiki getting a sentry and Observer down. Diving deeper, and the comeback Midas is the call for AUI 2000. Actually doing better than any of the other supports already. So he'll be looking for that Aghanim Scepter, I imagine, next.
Well, that tells us what direction DC are going to put this game in. I mean, they're just going to try to just split push and probably
late
avoid
game?
Fights. Go for late game.
I mean, they're fighting into three late game cores.
I mean, I don't...
And a Wyvern and a Legion.
Yeah, I don't love that decision, but...
Yeah, what else can they do, right?
They can't fight now, and...
They, like, the fights that I see DC winning are where BKBs are low, like, low duration, they get wasted, and then heroes just melt to the magic damage, but... I feel like there's that window where
like
you get
the game's gonna be over before
they have. They have the two 10-second BKBs. Legion's almost got one. You get all three of these, you could just run at them on high ground, and what are they actually gonna do? They have to vacuum, Quapple, Venoult, Eclipse, and then like
Darkseer, Wall,
all at once before you pop your BKBs, or they do no damage. They are split pushing, but they will be forced back. Screw the BKB, it's being flown out for the Legion, but they're not gonna wait around for this, and they hack away at the tower. Z-Talk just lumbering in. Something you doing?
This is a man of
peace. He wants the first lane of Rex. The captain makes the call. An unknown answer it. Working away quickly.
This is
they
a
They don't
team
have
of
the
action.
Aegis, but they've already done massive structural damage, and they just walk back.
That.
Good discipline here under pressure. Like the shot calling from unknown. They just took 3/4 of a tier 3.
For nothing.
I mean, I think they lost 2 tier 2s for that, but they also took a... What was it, a tier 2 as well along the way?
Yeah, I mean, they didn't lose a hero. They didn't have to use BKB charges.
Actually, they took a tier 1 and a tier 2, right? I can't remember, but it took at least 2 times.
Their lanes are pushed in, but...
Yeah, they got 2.
I think they're just waiting for this Rosh to be up, but it is a very long duration Rosh. Actually,
I think DC,
max.
DC, to me, have to contest that Rosh. If they give an Aegis to TA, probably the candidate... And you've got the triple BKB.
Maybe you get a magic vacuum wall on the high ground, and unknown is stuck there. I think that's pretty much their only hope.
That's their play.
Yeah, for contesting Rosh. Try and vacuum the TC on, or try and vacuum the Templar Assassin on the cliff.
And they are on the move. DC, a big smoke rotation. They may find Ryo. He blinks.
Oh,
quick
wow.
Reactions
what
there.
A great
so
reaction
much for
time.
Lag. Bulba hunts, he backs, they're committing for this, but they get up the BKB and Blade Mail. They can't even scratch him right now. Bulba caught out, Queen of Panel comes from behind. Hoshimiki unable to do a whole lot, but Bulba's on the run. The BKB cores
all
are going
DC
in deep. AUI shredded. Turning back, BKBs have started to wear off though. TA down, Gyro arrives to turn this. TC scrambling the retreat. They've gotten a couple, but they're going to lose TC as well. It looks like slowly ticking down. Queen of Pain still here. Gyro could be next. It's 4 dead. It might be 5. DC, call it a comeback.
Oh my
have
God,
they done
what?
It? They've done it.
What?
They never got off the Winter's Curse or the duel. That was the fight. The two massive lockdown abilities never cast. And on the back of it, DC, a 3K gold swing back their way at the tensest possible moment. And what do you know? Rosh still 2 minutes off.
I can't
oh,
believe
mama.
They lost that.
We've got ourselves a ball game.
I don't even...
I think they need to kill the Luna when they BKB, because as soon as BKBs were done...
That was Yawar, though. Yawar got the silence off on the Wyvern, which prevented a Winter's Curse.
But yeah, as soon as the BKBs were done, the Luna just turned on ulti and killed them all.
Diving. Once. The Wyvern again. Big commitment. Now TPing out, sees those respawn timers and says, screw this. Let's get back. So Hoshimiki, mercy was had for him. He'll be bloodlusted back in the fountain, healing himself up for a quicker movement out. That was like the worst possible engagement for unknown. No duel, no Winter's Curse, really good Queen of Pain ult, decent vacuum wall. I think, what, 3 or 4 heroes hit by the Venoult as well?
Gyro was also super late to the fight.
I don't think that's happening again,
no,
though.
No, but they need at least, I think they need like one more of those, and then maybe they can take more regular fights, but yeah, it's going to be tough. Yeah, also, bear in mind, TA has a Yasuo now with Bloodlust. She is incredibly fast, and they are going to smoke. Not scouted by the Dire. Roshan about to respawn 20, 30 seconds off, and they just scurry down mid, hunting for pickoffs.
And the thing about these max duration Rosh respawns is both teams are, well, they're going to know when it's up because of the TA trap, but DC are going to know it's up just because of the timer. So we might see a pretty big fight over this last over this Rosh, because, I mean, I think if unknown get this Rosh, it seems pretty unlikely.
I mean, after there's always potential for throw. We saw that. We saw that earlier. You can have a big lead, a much bigger lead than this, and still lose it.
We saw that twice.
Yeah. Well, once in particular, but yeah, we did see it twice today. But with an Aegis, that just gives them the insurance policy they're looking for. TA, the one to grab the Aegis. Top lane is pushing. They may want to back, get these lanes going their way, even mid going in, before they try to force a lane of Rex. And honestly, doesn't really feel like they need to force anything if they don't want to. There's still a tier 2 mid. There's a tier 2 top. They've got plenty of room to grow in terms of item progression. Gyro working towards the SNY still could get a big damage item. TA with a SNY or Manta to come at some point this game. Your Legion can pick up the Basher potentially next. And it's not like DC are out of control fat by any means. So we'll see what the desire is here. As Hoshimiki has 2270 gold.
He's probably going to pick up the dagger.
Yeah, this could be the difference maker. Last time he gets caught by Quap, he has a dagger there. Maybe he's able to get away.
The other thing is, so Luna just bought a BKB, which is good in some senses, but still she can just get dueled and brought down by the TA. I mean,
you need it, but it doesn't keep you
amazing
safe.
This game. It's not like the Radiant BKBs, which just absorb basically everything.
Yeah, but it's necessary. I don't disagree with the pickup. Otherwise she would just get slowed by Gyro ulti and stunned by Ogre.
Yeah, stunned by Ogre I think is a big thing.
Do they want to smoke again? This is a bit of a deep smoke. DC are playing very defensively here. The line is drawn deep into DC jungle territory, but it's the top lane that's pushing. Not sure if they're going to find anyone at this rate. They decide to wrap around on the top lane. Bulba tucked in the trees. The rats are out in full force as Buryu also hides. They draw to the left, but they run the ogre to the right. Now swinging back.
All of DC is hiding. I definitely know this.
They're playing keep away. In fact, they're TPing out. They're starting to get a bit nervous, it looks like. Would like to see a gem here for Unknown sometime soon.
Yeah, try to take a little bit of map control back. There's a lot of dire wards down in some very, very key places.
And very easily dewarded places as well.
Yeah, that's true.
Well, I think they're out of smokes for a while. 3.5 minutes, and then none for 11 minutes.
DC is evacuated, they're all out of there, and now they're actually smoking themselves.
Oh, they're smoking into it. This is super risky. They've got no vision either.
They need to catch the gyrocopter.
They do see two heroes top now. They see two top. Moving forward, they're gonna find the Legion commander. Get slept, not able to pop the BKB, but Gyro's coming from behind. He gets the cooldown off on two heroes. They still lose
him. They need more. The Gyro can't. I don't think
he wants to fight.
But he is here.
Where's the detection? Buryu, Glimmer Cape, the plays, runs the wrong direction. Looks like he might make it out. Not so lucky as Bulba tries for the high ground vacuum. Almost got it too.
So they
trade a Darkseer and a Smoke for a Legion.
Worth. They need trades are good for them at this point.
Slight win going their way. Also, keeping the Legion dead means likely Unknown not going to try to take high ground yet. Only 2 minutes to go on the Sages. Man, this game is tense.
It's very, very close.
And it's like, it's sometimes you watch a game, you feel like you know exactly what's going to happen. At this point, I have no idea
who's
going to
win.
Next.
I still think that, I mean, Unknown definitely have a window here, I think, for like the next 10 minutes or so. But eventually, Luna's going to get some physical damage items. Already working towards.
I mean, if it gets to the point where Luna has, you know, I don't know, Butterfly, MKB, Satanic, Scotty, you get the Venno Ags level 3 ultimate out in the middle of a team fight, the big vac wall. That is a disgusting amount of damage, but it's just not burst damage, and it's not. They don't have the most reliable lockdown, is the main concern for them. So their ceiling is high, but the ability to execute required is also higher. Like, all you have to do to start a fight is Unknown, just blink in and Winter's Curse or duel. You gotta hit the combos if you're DC.
Well, Aoi does have his eggs.
Big component of the combo.
I mean, they still have this Aegis. I think I'd rather see Unknown pressuring a little bit here.
I feel like they are resting on their laurels a little bit. I feel like fights for them are so easy at this point, especially with those BKBs, but
And checking the durations, 9, 9, and 9. So they're going to take the next tier 2. At this point, Aegis expires. Maybe they wait one more Roche, and then they go.
You know what chat's going to start spamming now that you've said that.
Hope our mods are good.
You're just watching with, like, bated breath. Yeah, Charlie. Yeah. So excited for this.
There we go. Here it comes,
boys.
Boop, boop.
DC is doing a good job of pushing out bot lane again, making it really hard for Unknown to commit to top without taking some risk. And down goes the Aegis. 5 more minutes until Roshan. So, pretty average Rosh timing.
Yeah, this is good discipline from TA. Leaves the trap in the pit. So they'll know as soon as it respawns. They won't get caught by a DC sneak attempt. Went opted to go back for the Manta this game. To me,
so you know what?
Somewhat curious choice. What can you Manta off here?
Does have the Orchid.
Can you Manta off
BKB,
the poison
so.
Slow?
Maybe the
not the damage, but maybe the slow.
I know you can't with Viper Strike, but nothing removes that. Not even Slark's Dark Pact.
I don't know. Snide him, I guess.
Look at this. Just a little group hug, team huddle, before they move out.
You know what this feels like to me? This feels like Unknown are just waiting for their time to end the game.
I'll bury you. No, he doesn't see him.
Oh, he canceled it.
Oh, they have no idea he's there though. But he's not going to be there for the fight.
Just a lost, lonely Bane.
If they just push here, he's not going to be there.
Pacing back and forth, trapped in his cave. Where does he go? What does he do with his life?
Oh, they're smoked. They're going for
45 seconds right where now. He's hiding in the trees.
And without Bane at this fight, I don't know.
I would feel bad for Bane, but he's a pretty disgusting.
I feel like they really need that BKB.
And Roche.
Stun.
Still a couple minutes off, so he should be back in time. It looks like it may amount to nothing in the end. 30 seconds to go. The smoke about to wear off, and now no smokes for 11 minutes. So they are going to have to wait some time before they can actually make plays. That was...
I wonder if Unknown should just, like... I think Unknown, should, after the next Roche, just needs to group and push.
Yeah, they already cleared up the tier 2.
Like, they're smoking. They're not finding any kills. I think you just group and push.
Yeah.
You have BKBs. They still don't really have anything to deal with it.
No, I agree. This is pretty much...
I don't even think they really need the pickoff to like make this, a fight happen. How is Bird still sitting there?
He just cooled down on his TP.
I think what they're scared of is going up high ground and then, you know, Bulba blinks in with a vacuum wall and then, you know...
He's moving.
Venomancer throws his...
All right. I'm back on the field, guys. Oh, DD rune. Nice grab for the Legion Commander. Up to 3,200 gold. Could get that Assault Caress soon if he so pleases. Maybe a Basher once in a while. We'll see.
Oh, they're not even going to wait for the Mare. Are they not even going to wait for the Roche? Are they just going to push?
They should definitely wait for the Roche.
It's like,
I mean,
so close now.
They should still respect the Blink Vacuum Wall. Still
they should get some vision up around the pit, ideally.
DC pushing top lane in. Looks like Unknown are just going to push bot. The line is drawn.
Is this a race?
Now, is this the push bot and then draw them back? Or is this the push bot and we're killing your base?
I mean, they have
they waste the glyph.
Oh, God.
DC, slow on the draw here. And meanwhile, the Wyvern looking to cancel TPs. The rest of the team going to back. Organized team play here.
Roche?
If they cancel a couple TPs, maybe they go. But instead, they're going to hide in the trees. So they think there's a ward up there?
I think so.
Not sure. There is nothing. And they're moving out the Luna. TC just rumbles out all on his
God.
Own. He does get off his ultimate, but now the cooldown's coming in. They're walking into it. They hammer away at him with physical damage. A full duration eclipse does nothing. 1-2 down. TA going in on a Buryu. The last auto tech misses, courtesy of the Glimmer Cape. Now Yuar starts to work on him. Might be able to kill off the TA, but not before he dies as well. Another grab. Can they save him? No, the ward plinks him down. AUI with the triple. The
What?
A 4-for-4 exchange.
Venomancer.
But almost all of those kills from beyond the grave, which means
no experience
for DC.
So if Bulba had gotten off the vacuum, that would have been very different. But he just vacuumed a bunch of BKB heroes and it did nothing. And again,
Eclipse also, again, did nothing.
Venomancer is such a disgusting hero. I agree with you, Charlie. I can't believe that just happened.
Well,
I don't think I've ever seen. I don't think I've ever seen a Vino get an ultra.
Now
kill
bear in
like
mind
that.
They did not have the Wyvern in that fight. That's the other thing, because he TP'd home and didn't get a TP cancel.
Maybe he would have gotten the AIDS too.
He may have also died, but I guess they killed almost everyone anyway. But perhaps he disables someone before they get off their big spells. Still, an Assault Caress nearly completed on your Legion Commander. Things getting tense here down the stretch. The Peruvians, Unknown, striving to become the first ever team, not only from Peru, but from South America in its entirety, to attend a major or of other Valve-organized event, such as the International. But Rocha's Respawn and DC are going for it. I believe they had a trap in the pit. Pretty sure that Unknown know about this. TA only now respawning. Roche, a rather slow go here.
Oh my god.
Everyone's spells are back online.
They
the full
are going.
Complement, aside from the Venowolt, up in 10 seconds. They're committing for this, and Yawar is tanking a lot of damage. Roche about to fall. Z-Talk taking his time. They want to have somebody in position here.
The
Glimmer forward from Buryu runs directly. God. The Ogre going to get deleted immediately by the TA. And now Bulba jumps in. BKB's a plenty coming up. Bulba destroyed. Now they curse TC.
Life
He's
one
the
is
Aegis
gone.
Carrier. Yawar onto the high ground searching for the ultimate opportunity, but it's on cooldown for now. 3 seconds. Has it. Let's it fly. It's decent. TC comes back to life. Where's the follow-up to bring him down? Gyrocopter's on the run. TA's busy in her own little world trying to kill off supports and will kill grab the Venno. Ends up being a 3-for-2 with an Aegis pop. So I guess 2-for-4 favoring
good
Unknown.
Play for Unknown.
I think when they went on to Buryu and he just stood there and they all sort of converged on him, Bulba missed a big opportunity to just vacuum wall all of that.
And then they got their BKBs off.
Yeah.
The timing's got to be crisp. And that is one of the issues with the draft. There's only just inches of opportunity.
All right, my headset is broken.
We're working on it, Charlie, and we'll get you back soon. Your headset breaking, perhaps a metaphor for your brain. Oof. The way this game is
definitely
going.
A metaphor for my brain. Well, TA is still just... TA actually has 6,000 gold. I have to assume he will buy an item. Some point soon.
Daedalus or MKB? There's
Gyro already went MKB. I mean, Butterfly seems like it would have been. I don't know. Now that Gyro already has MKB,
you just want more damage during your BKB. Like, yeah. He's not dying to physical damage, he's dying to nukes. And as soon as his BKB wears off, he's gonna die. So yeah, I think this is the preferred build. Daedalus or MKB. Since there's no Solar Crest currently.
What?
Go for it. And the interesting grab by Aeon.
I mean, it's actually really good.
This is
okay. Against
TA. This is a good pickup versus TA and the Legion.
Even DC.
Honestly, Venno, like, if they can grab AUI first, to me, it's him or Bulba is the two most important.
Venno is the second highest net worth on DC right now.
Chat wanted a rapier. Not in this situation,
unlikely.
Guys. This is not the time to buy a rapier.
Yeah, that would be super throwy.
Maybe if it's a pub. Not when you're just
not when you're
breath away from
for,
the major.
Yeah, qualifier for a $3 million Valve major. Well, we're getting... What do you think, Unknown? Do you think Unknown or have to wait for the next Roche now, or are they just going to push?
Yeah, I would wait for the
they
Roche.
They also almost
honestly.
Have an AC. They definitely want to wait for that. DC are more magic damage, but still big item. I would actually love to see a pipe for Unknown. I'm not sure who can farm it.
It's
like Wyvern's going for a fresher. Yeah, I guess they don't have the best candidate, but...
They have so much map control, and DC is so scared now. You might as well just take your time and...
They did scout heroes running through the river.
And get the items that you need. The last thing you want is to pull a reverse DC and walk uphill and get like vacuum wall, 5-hero vacuum walled into a Venomancer.
Reverse DC. That's one way of putting it.
Just watching our producer in action.
Just trying to meme it up.
But.
Game's quiet as it looks like. I think you're right. They're just going to wait a little bit.
And keep an eye on BKB durations. These are quite important. Seconds on, I believe, all three carries. So they're getting pretty low now.
Yeah.
The Venno ult remains just as devastating all game long.
I feel like there is a clock on this for Unknown.
They can win ultra late. It's more if they screw up, they're punished more for it because they don't have the long duration BKBs.
But there's still
room. They can
room.
Get so big, Greg. Yeah. Like these heroes have so much room to farm.
There's still room to grow. TA can still get a moon shard.
They're just going in.
She's got a free moon shard.
Oh my god, look how fast she attacks with press the attack.
Alpha Wolf wants have a little piece of the puzzle as well. That big old beefy 1400 HP Alpha Wolf.
They definitely want to keep that alive. Yeah, cold embrace it.
I love it.
But heal that bad boy.
It's on cooldown now. Gotta wait it out. Measly and feeble comes through, but hardly even scratches the TA's massive physical damage output.
Look at how much damage he has with refraction up. 286 additional damage over his 173 base, and he has the Daedalus. So
Satanic almost ready on TC, but not quite.
I do want to give
credit. They jump in. Focusing immediately on Melee Rex. Tia gonna Mantle Style right off the bat. The cooldown comes through. TC left on his own. He's got a cheese and he's baiting with it. He will pop it now. And the TA's forced back as the Legion engages onto AOI 2000, but he already got off his ultimate. They might have to run here. Bulba gets the back. They've been punished. They've overextended a bit, but DC still falling to the Gyro's auto attack damage. The Flat Cannon did its work. A 4-for-2. They got the Rex. They get out freely. An excellent Winter's Curse there down the stretch to help secure the fight.
And Gyro lives.
Oh,
what a TP.
They just win the fight too fast. DC need time. They need that fight to go 15 seconds, not 5 to 10.
TA is just so massive.
You know, a lot of the issues with how DC defend high ground has been they just let the hero walk up.
They,
and start
they don't punish. Yeah, there's no high ground advantage for them because they just let the TA waltz up there.
Right. They need to take a lot of these fights before, like, as they're walking up or before they're just hitting your racks. Just go in. Stop being so scared.
They also did commit a buyback there in AUI. Bear that in mind. And once again, Legion wins another duel up to 110 bonus damage. That's already a free Abyssal Blade, minus the Passion active.
Yeah, the beauty of Legion Commander is you don't really have to build damage. You can just build survivability because the damage just comes by itself.
Yeah, and, well, the other thing is that they have an Ogre. Like,
yeah.
I feel Tusk brings so much more for a lot of the early to mid game, but if you get to this point and you're on the offensive, Ogre is just ridiculous as a support.
They get a really good in-base.
Especially with this draft. They've got three heroes that can really use the Bloodlust.
I also want to say, I do want to give some credit to TC, despite how terrible so many parts about this game have been going for DC. He's kept up in farm pretty well.
Yeah, he's still only a little bit behind the TA, who is just still absolutely massive. He is gargantuan.
Speaking
they
of gargantuan,
refresher.
Yeah. Refresher, Winter Wyvern.
If he gets that off at... Even if it's just two solo heroes,
yeah,
they
sure
win the fight.
It just seems like the game would be over at that point.
Oh, the rune of many wins for Unknown. For DC, a rune that at least lets them stay in the game. But, I mean, Charlie, it's like you said. They are just scared as all hell. They are cowering in their base.
The biggest problem with this is
patrolling the throne.
They can't, you know, TC cannot farm nearly as efficiently if they're stuck in their base like this. And they need him to get massive.
Both teams actually chilling in their base now. I don't want to back.
They might be scared that they're smoked.
Both teams expecting the other to be smoked and nobody is. Oh. Okay.
Unknown.
A little fun to be had
here.
Time
to push out.
By the way, notice no shenanigans right now for your boy here on the gyrocopter. He's playing serious mode. He was clowning around yesterday.
There is no Null Talisman dropping.
Yeah, no MKB dropping. Should they win, expect the swag to come out.
Expect him to drop all of his items. He'll probably buy Dagon or something. I don't know. Who knows? They're going to get this double damage. And
with a Bloodlusted TA.
Is Roshan up?
He could be very soon. Let's see. 30 seconds. And they're just going
to
camp the rune. Wait for the Rosh respawn.
Well, they need to take it before. They need to take the rune before 48.
They can wait 10 seconds, grab this rune, and Rosh will just be up. He's going to grab it now.
And they...
And they do see this movement. Buryu, they'll deward the traps. God, my kingdom for a smoke. And guess what? They've got one, and they're drawing the line. It's straight down bottom lane, directly into the heart of DC. Who gets the jump here? This is so crucial. Bulba only just arriving to position now. In front is the gyrocopter. Rushes in off the bat. Call down to fly. They don't have the refresher Winter's Curse, but they dual TC. He didn't get off the Eclipse. Blade Mail not really doing a whole hell of a lot.
The
Queen of Pain comes through, but it seems like too much physical damage. Buryu gets pounded. The Peruvians are on the verge. It's up to Bulba to turn. He gets a beautiful vacuum wall. Is it going to be enough damage? They start TPing out.
TC's back.
TC buys back. He returns to the fray, but the TA cleans up on the rear. Continues to run. Might be able to turn on TC. No, there's backup. Yuar's also here. Needs to blink out. The poison wearing off soon. One more Lucent Beam. Refraction about to come off cooldown. Needs to turn and fight. This is going to go down. They buy the refresher. They've got double buybacks ready. And looking at Digital Chaos, they used one. They have nothing available on the Venno. Ended's on cooldown.
There's a trap
and they've only
Rosh.
Got a Darkseer and a Quap. All big ultimates were expended.
There is a trap in Roche. They know this is happening, but unfortunately, there's no way they can even get to Roche, really. So
that gyrocopter TP'd out with a sliver of life left. TC was so close to killing him.
And he didn't have buyback, actually.
Yeah, that would have been so huge if he had died. Might have been DC's way to get back into this game, but...
The other reason that fight went so well is Winter Wyvern basically zoned Bulba. Bulba got cursed way back by the stairs on the Dire side up to the high ground, and as a result, he was super late with the vacuum wall. I mean, when it came, it was great, but if it had been there, 10 seconds earlier...
They didn't have, the other big thing, they did not have the refresher on Wyvern.
Oh, yeah, and he has it now, and
he was
up
a little far back. The team kind of got away from him, and he couldn't quite get in position, but potentially big item.
Yeah.
All right, let's grab the Hex. Remember, DC trailing one game in the best of three. Lose this, they go home empty-handed. We'll view the majors from the comfort of North America. A win here, we go to a even more stressful game number three, I imagine. It's neck and neck, really. 10,000 gold. Actually, not neck and neck anymore. It was neck and neck. That last couple of fights and the buybacks, plus the laner axe, really hurting DC. Still, they hang on. Looking for the big plays.
Another 5,000 gold for this TA. This TA farms so efficiently, gets so many kills. He has 391 CS, and TC has 419. TC has glaives. So... this TA is farming very,
TA's
very
also
well.
Been allowed to leave the base a lot.
Yeah,
more.
That's true. He kind of gets to walk around and do what he pleases.
Now that there's a Hex, there's a little more chance of getting ganked. But prior to that, the only way you're dying without BKB TP out is a grip. So I think that's why you see all three of their cores, well, at least the first two, pretty high up there in the CS charts.
I always picked up a dagger.
Oh.
I think...
long range, disgustingness.
Smoke for DC.
They didn't get TC. They're going to show him on mid. Up on the high ground, TA lurks. Might break the smoke. Buryu revealed. Drops the ward. Blinks out.
Wow.
And DC's really Gambit blink. Is going to be an air ball.
Are they just going for it?
DC does not win a base race unless they start hitting racks way sooner.
I think Unknown is going for it. Double TP's back.
And this is where TP's are important. If there does become a base race scenario. Or if one does arise, I should say.
Unknown need to TP back. They have a decent wave in Luna. Alright, I guess they're just gonna...
Tower is actually gonna die to this if they don't back. Looks like they want to fight, though. TC out in front. Remember, he's the Aegis carry. Also, Satanic, the committee law for this. They get the duel in. Off the bat, TC dead once. The curse, Aoi, as a follow-up. Killing him would be massive if he doesn't get off the Poison Nova.
I think it only
hit a single hero. That might be the difference maker.
Oh, TC's cursed!
TC, locked down, shut down, and dead. No buyback for 120 seconds. The Aegis has not worked its magic. Buryu also forced to TP out. They only lose one. It costs two for Unknown, as well as an Aegis. And the Venomancer's Poison Sting may hang on. They're going to buy back the Legion. He TP's on mid.
I think they might just try and go for
back.
It.
Do they commit? They're down in Ogre, but also the Luna gone. The Veno ult on cooldown only for 30 seconds longer, though.
They don't have a vacuum wall either.
Yeah, Luna down, wall is down. That sounds
Poison
like...
Poison Nova's going to be up, and they will have no Winter's Curses for this fight.
Z-Talk just drew a line down middle.
As BKBs will also be up.
They're healing up the TA with Cold Embrace.
Ideally, you want to push top here, since the bottom lane has to be dealt with, I think. But
yeah.
They got to be careful with the Legion. Dieback here in Raya could be costly. Racks are exposed mid now due to that aggressive movement.
Ultimately, so TC goes out expecting to bait and his team to back him up, but they just weren't close enough.
Close enough, and the other thing is if they just turn on BKB, is like the best thing that can happen is Bane... gets a grip, but they have a couple ways to stop that as well. And now they're just going to go up on the high ground again.
Aoi with the Poison Nova. Could just safely back out if they want to, but they're going to let Bulba vacuum them. Yawar there trying to stall this. No wall. They pop mass BKBs, and now they want to retreat, but they're taking a lot of damage here. This could be a dieback for the Legion Commander, potentially. The cooldown comes through, and the big AoE goes out. Buryu down. Curse has just cooled down in time for Bulba to die. Yawar's going to be next, potentially. Blinks away, barely surviving, but in through the front door. They smash it down. AUI's next. The grip is there from Buryu. Everybody buys back. A triple buyback on Digital Chaos as they just hemorrhage gold. The back wall's there. They need all these kills. They might even need more than that. The TA glimmered, running, retreating, surviving, blinking out. No way does he escape this, but he does.
I think DC at this point, they just go down mid. Just
jam down mid. Hope for the best.
Hope for the best.
I can't believe they didn't get the TA. She's got 8,000 gold. She can buy an item and have buyback, but does need to get home to base.
50 seconds, and they will have the double Winter Wyvern ulti once again.
The hero ogre shoving in the top lane.
Bloodlusting those creeps.
Zook, zook.
I mean,
work.
The lack of duel here is a real problem.
He's hitting creeps, man. I'm loving this ogre. But DC,
I mean, they
need a lot here. There's a glyph available for the Radiant. The doubles Winter's Curse is up in 20 seconds, but they may lose the gyrocopter off the bat. Has the Satanic, has the BKB. Great save coming out. And now the TA engages. BKB going strong for the meanwhile, but the gyro will die. Buy spec immediately. They're trying to herd the TA back to the well. Looking to commit in further. Will be slept for now. And they look to turn onto Buryu. Creeps are pushing. Buryu's dead. That's a buyback, or a dieback rather. And now a two hero curse.
Oh, they're stuck.
Hoshimiki locking them down, finishing them off. Bulba's next. It's a full wipe. Four. Unable to buy back. The line is drawn. Top and unknown. This game firmly within their grasp. BOT's the buy. The tier 4 is exposed.
TA.
Unknown are going to Frankfurt. The first ever team from South America to do it.
That's amazing.
Wow. This is going to be huge for SA.
This is huge for that entire South American scene.
Can you believe it?
I got some goosebumps from South American team going to Major. Yeah.
Awesome. They deserve this.
They played so well.
Absolutely did.
They played so well. That was a seriously unbelievable performance from Unknown. The Peruvian flag is rising.
The
flag
pool.
I have to assume that the
national
anthem is
playing. How long did
you
work on that for?
And this is amazing.
Viva Peru!
That's unbelievable. I mean, honestly, that game felt like, even after the triple kill, it just wasn't really going DC's way. Yawar definitely had some issues at the beginning of the game, and pretty unbelievable.
Wow. He put so much time into his victory celebration.
Well...
Is that a chip?
That's it.
No. He doesn't get
that
it.
Was an he just manually produced a flag going
that's
up a
true,
pole.
That's true, that's
Give
true.
The man a break.
Incredible.
Yeah.
Give Rob a medal as well while we're at it. At Ice Element. Oh, my God. I can't believe they did it.
That's
if anyone was going to pick a Peruvian or South American team to go to the major, it was not Unknown.
No,
it was definitely Elite Wolves every time. This is like CDEC at TI to me as far as like there's no way anyone's picking this team in their predictions.
They've come so far. There was actually a lot of hype surrounding well, not a lot of hype, but there's Kotaro Hayama, their safe lane player, was somebody known in North America as a pretty skilled player. He was part of the team that knocked out Jimmy's team from the TI qualifiers. From the open qualifiers.
Right, because they changed the roster. So
right. So, you know, it's really amazing to see how far a lot of these players have come, especially, like, you know, Elite Wolves, Unknown. There's a lot of talent all over the world.
And I think you said it yesterday that Peru is very similar to the Philippines in the sense, like, the fans there
are
rabid
for
Dota.
Yeah,
crazy.
Yeah.
They love Dota.
This is going to do so much for that scene. I'm actually really excited to see what happens with Peru following the major.
Yeah.
Who knows? Maybe they'll make a good showing while they're there. It's going to be stiff competition, a new experience for these guys, but...
Right.
Maybe inject some new investment in the Peruvian scene, give them a little bit of opportunity.
Perhaps we see some bigger events migrating there.
Sure.
Only one way to find out.
Yeah.
But that's the end of the America qualifier.
America is over. China still remains. IG and Newbie were duking it out. Mm-hmm. Not sure if we have a result on that one just yet. Let's see if we... Trusty old Liquipedia has been updated. I think it's just 1-0 right now. It's 1-0 with Newbie leading in the best of three. Loser will play Newbie Young for the final slot.
Yep.
So the team I thought would be the kind of hot underdog, CDEC Young, ended up falling short in the tiebreakers.
I don't even remember who I picked. I just remember I picked IG Newbie.
Safe bet.
Nice pick, Charlie.
Thanks, dude.
Nice job. Brilliant. Well, I think we're going to be switching out Cruz.
I am so happy for the South American fans.
It's actually so
for this
awesome.
Team, Unknown. Because they had a lot of adversity this tournament. The server issues, the constant packet loss. Not to mention, they lose. They get just destroyed by Cloud9 and then immediately have to go play DC. They almost lost game one.
Oh, yeah. If they had lost that game, that would have been so demoralizing to lose like that. But they held it together really well. They're faced with not so many options in game one while they're getting ratted, but they found a way to win.
Well, for DC, I guess the other side of the coin, this has to be a major disappointment.
That is crushing for them.
For everybody involved.
Yeah. The organization, the players, the fans.
Oh, yeah. There's
that team has so much individual talent, but it just feels like there's no leadership.
There's no one to bring it all together and to make that call to take them to a win. Yeah.
Definitely agreed.
Mm-hmm. Maybe we'll see roster changes. I guess with the new major.
I'm sure we're seeing roster changes.
My real question is how much? Is it like one or two players?
Did they qualify for a single LAN at all?
I'll say two players.
Two players.
At least.
Two players is kind of safe. I'll go with two. Actually, I'm going to say three. I think three players. Just because I can't pick your number.
Oh, okay. Okay.
Well, that was a lot of fun, guys. I hope you enjoyed it. I believe this is the last cast for each of us, so be sure to follow Gerg here at What Is Hip TV, at Charlie C. Yang, two wonderful managers, and, well, of course, Ice Element, our brilliant producer.
I didn't even realize there's a Peruvian flag.
They're not even listening to what we're saying. They're just watching all this nonsense. Yeah, we're going to hop over to China soon. We'll bring in the crew. Gods, Winter, possibly Merlini. Not sure. Somebody else will